Thank you. Good afternoon. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. Gentlemen, please remove your caps. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. At this time, I respectfully ask that all cell phones, pagers, or electronic devices be turned off as to provide our graduation ceremony the dignity and respect it deserves. Please refer to the message to the class of 2016 and their guests at this time. This message is located on the back of your program. Commencement is an academic milestone evolved from nearly 1,000 years of history. While it is a day of joy and celebration, the ceremony itself requires dignity and quiet respect. We are aware that many of you have attended sporting events in this place when cheering and whistles were appropriate and acceptable behavior. However, noisemaking and other disruptive behavior are unacceptable during Honesdale High School commencements. We request your cooperation in giving the ceremony appropriate reverence and providing all of our graduates the honor and respect each has earned and each deserves. We are pleased that we are able to video stream the commencement ceremony to Honesdale High School Auditorium. Because filming cameras are continuously operating, we ask that the noise level in this area be kept to a minimum in order for the best sound quality to be transmitted to the auditorium for friends and family in attendance there. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Thinking about beginning a new journey in my life has made me reflect on where I've been. Talking with my classmates about our elementary school days brings back excellent memories of such innocent, carefree times. Our only worries in the world were whether our mom packed our favorite snack in our lunch or if we would be the first one to the swings at recess. Young kids live a carefree lifestyle and have such big dreams. I honestly think we can all learn a great deal about life from them. The key is that we have to focus on what we love. Take a moment and think about what your answer would have been in third grade to the question, what do you want to be when you grow up? We have all been asked this question so many times, and I'm sure we all had many different crazy answers. Personally, in third grade, I wanted to be a dentist because I loved going to get my teeth cleaned. And in fourth grade, I wanted to be a vet because I wanted to save animals. And I know our very own valedictorian has told me that he wanted to be a piano-playing, firefighting space doctor. Recently, I decided to ask a few of my little cousins this question, and I got some great answers. The responses ranged from being a dog walker, to a teacher, to a police officer, and to my personal favorite, a zebra keeper. One of my cousins, who is 4 years old, had a very simple answer to my question. Her answer was, I want to be five. When I asked them why they wanted to grow up to have these jobs, the answers were similar. They all had the common idea of wanting to help the world we live in. My little cousins all have a passion, whether it is for saving animals or teaching math. They have chosen what they want to be based on that passion. Their answers didn't have anything to do with the amount of money they would make in that particular job or the benefits they would receive from it, because they simply don't have that mindset. I'm sure all of our third grade selves had similar intentions. Now, I know for some of us, it wouldn't be reasonable to live out our third grade dream in our world today. Maybe we wouldn't make enough money to live on, or perhaps the dream is otherwise unrealistic. However, we should not lose that passion we had and that mindset that we can be anything we want to be. All of us can do anything we set our minds to. It's all a matter of allowing ourselves to recognize our dreams and of truly encouraging ourselves to work hard for what we love. It is so important that we take hold of our dreams. Never think that something is out of reach, because we all have a capability of helping our world, just as we thought we did when we were young. Think of all the extraordinary people we hear of that were told as kids they weren't going to amount to anything in life. Walt Disney, J.K. Rowling, and Vincent van Gogh are among these people. Even Albert Einstein's teacher told his parents that he was never going to be successful and that he wasn't capable of learning. If all of these people did not have the passion and the drive to follow their dreams and do what they loved, our world would be very different today. We would never dream of going to Disney World, spend our childhood wishing we could be a wizard like Harry Potter, appreciate the Starry Night painting, or know how to relate energy to mass with the equation E equals mc squared. Our world would be something less if each and every one of us does not go out into the world and conquer our dreams. I challenge everyone, whether you are in the class of 2016 or not, to do what you love. Make your life everything you want it to be. Make your third grade self happy. As Henry David Thoreau said, go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life you have imagined.
Today is a day to celebrate our success, not just as students, but as people who are driven and people who achieve great things. We faced many challenges in our 12 years of school, taking tests, creating projects, making friends, losing friends, being a friend, being responsible, and just managing the stress of all of that at once. But we also lived by this guideline, to always be the best we can be. What is it that keeps us so motivated and focused? I will tell you. It is that we are dreamers. We all have passion for something, and we turn that passion into action to achieve our dreams. When we talk about dreams, we're always talking about the future. What do you want to be when you grow up? People have dreams of owning a house on the beach, of getting that dream job, of serving their country or God, or of changing the world for the better. These are great dreams, and we should always stay focused and work towards them. But we need to remember that happiness never lives or manifests in the future. Happiness is a state of living, and it lives in the present. So what do we do today to encourage happiness? We follow the dreams of today. Dreams of today are short-term goals that we can accomplish, and they are worth a great deal to our happiness. I'll share some of the dreams of today that I've had this year. I dreamed of football season with all of my friends. The nights may have been cold, but they didn't freeze our spirit. We cheered and we stamped our feet as Clay threw the ball and Julio scored a touchdown. And every time we won, the band would celebrate with some Barbara Ann. Those nights filled me with joy, and we worked hard to make them happen. I dreamed of doing well at the math competitions. Sometimes it didn't go as planned, but at the end of it all, Miss Wiegand was there to explain everything, and it was a learning experience. I dreamed of winning the Spirit Week senior year. Our class came together to dance and show off our many talents. We were filled with pride when we got that well-deserved first place. I dreamed of going to Disney World, the place where dreams come true. And it was a dream. We were there for a week, and the sky was blue every day, and it was warm and sunny. Things like that only happen in a dream, and I'll always treasure the happiness that that trip brought me and the lessons I learned. For example, don't feed the ducks because they'll follow you. And when they do finally leave, they'll come back with friends. I dreamed of making a difference at the blood drive. By now, we all know that one pint saves three lives. Well, we saved a lot of lives. And what dream is better than that? It not only shows our dedication to the community, but also our character and our willingness to serve others. I dreamed of jumping off the rock at Devil's Well. I never made it. But a lot of you in this room overcame your fear and took the plunge. And on top of gaining courage and making a memory with your friends, you also gained bragging rights. I dreamed of going to work at Dessen. I don't just mean for the Dunkin' money, although that was nice, but for the animals and the rewarding feeling at the end of the day. There was a dog who came in completely emaciated, and he didn't trust anyone to touch him, and he wouldn't even make eye contact. But I was persistent. And you know what? One day, that dog curled up in my lap and fell asleep. That dream opened my eyes to the meaning of service, and that's when I learned what passion can do. When you unleash all of the love that you have for something and you carry in your heart, and you focus it, you become more. You're able to accomplish greater things. These are dreams of the present, the ones that inspire love and happiness. I hope that some of you have found that love during your time in high school. I hope it stays with you all of your life, and that you apply it every day to grant yourself that much more happiness. Your love for music, learning, service, sports, and most importantly, each other, has imprinted on your hearts, and it will serve you and guide you along your way. As we leave this room today to pursue the dreams of tomorrow, we may lose touch or find ourselves on a path entirely our own, but know that in each other, we can always find a friend and shared dreams. Thank you, class of 2016, for the memories and for sharing all of today's dreams. It was 12 years in the making, but we made this dream come true together today, graduation. Now it's on to bigger dreams. Let us follow them and see them through. Let us be proud of ourselves and support each other in everything that we do. Let us make every day count as a step towards happiness. We only get one life to live our passions out.
Our first musical presentation is an instrumental selection, As If on Wings by Tracy O'Berman. This song is written to encourage the seniors to spread their wings and soar as they realize their full potential.
The word dream carries with it notions of being grand, magical, and fantastical, not mundane and everyday. When we dream at night, we see ourselves driving sleek sports cars, not soccer mom minivans. Our daydreams we have while we sit boarding class are those of bold adventures we could be on, not those of the errands we need to run after school. The dreams we have while we are wide awake and focused, our dreams of the future, are just as exciting. Unfortunately, however, I think it is typical for most to take a dose of reality and gain a more pessimistic outlook on life as we grow older. This causes our dreams to fade into sad and boring ideas that I would not define as dreams any longer. When this happens, our lives may stagnate, and both our dreams and we may stop evolving. We cannot allow this to happen. We must continue to nurture our dreams and place them at the forefront of our lives, no matter what our futures may hold. I don't know. I don't know, and neither do any of you. None of us truly know what lies ahead in our future, where and who we will be in the coming years. Not only is everything around us constantly changing, but our own likes and dislikes and our thoughts and opinions change too. Think about it. Do any of us still think that paste or boogers are tasty? Do we still keep up to date on all the latest Pokemon? Well, I can't think of anyone else here who does. So, we may have a plan for what lies ahead, but in a second, something could change, and our plan could crumble right in front of our eyes. This is absolutely terrifying. There's something, however, that keeps us going. Something that makes us put on our big boy pants and overcome whatever obstacle comes our way, and that is our dreams. Our dreams are most potent when we are down in the dumps. We dream to feel joy. But if our dreams are subject to change, like everything else in this world, then why dream? Isn't this a waste of our time? The reason we must keep dreaming is that dreams are so vital, not because of the end goal, but because of what they serve to do. By dreaming, we create a drive in ourselves to work for the life that we desire, better than where we are now. Dreams push us to achieve things and to go beyond our current place in life. Our dreams will evolve and change with our opinions and our likes, but they always reflect where we are in our lives and are necessary to transition into our next ones. For example, there was a time when I thought of being a doctor in order to help improve people's lives, but now, as I have grown and changed, my dream has evolved. I know that I still want to improve people's lives, but I have realized that the way for me to do that is as a chemical engineer and not as a doctor. The specifics of the dream have changed, but it still remains to urge me on. So, as we sit here today, both my fellow students and those of you in the audience, think about what I've said. Think about how different you are and how much your dreams have changed since you started high school just a short time ago, or, for you older folk, a long, long time ago. Then, think about how much time there is for even more change. We must remember to follow our changing dreams no matter what. Then, each of us will be able to achieve great things and feel the joy we never would, that would never be possible without the simple act of dreaming.
Our second musical presentation is a vocal selection, It Takes a Village by Joan Zimko, performed by the Senior Vocal Ensemble.
It takes a whole village to raise one child. We all, everyone, must share the burden.
We all, everyone, will share the joy. It takes a whole village to raise our children. It takes a whole
At this time, I would like to introduce Honesdale High School Principal, Mrs. Scarfalata.
In your commencement program, you will find a list of seniors who have been notified that they have received scholarships and awards from colleges, schools, and organizations. These institutional awards total $1,981,436. Local and regional awards, as listed in your program, under awards and honors, total nearly $125,000. Honesdale High School has the good fortune of a very strong scholarship program. Our school community supports us well in many events, but it is overwhelmingly noticeable as the number of graduates time and again receive monies from community organizations, individual families, and from trusts to assist them in their education. We are ever grateful to all who provide scholarships, serve on selection committees, and support each graduating class so generously. At this time, I ask that all graduates who have received an award or scholarship this year stand and be recognized. Please honor these students with your applause. Each year at graduation, Honesdale High School honors its honor graduates. Graduating summa cum laude with a 4.0 or above GPA, Andrew Peter Bachnovich, Kylie A. Fermuth, Emma Kathleen Firmstone, Ryan Paul Fritz, Kaya Rose Lynch, Zoe D. Wasserloff, Tristan Lewis Protzman, Natalie Marie Tamlin, Janine Elizabeth Gallick, and Lauren Marie Bunnell. Graduating magna cum laude with a 3.83 to 3.999 GPA, Bradley Mark Welsh, Max Michael Goodwin, Elizabeth C. Fritz, Dorothy Esther Woods, Emma Morgan Long, Matthew Mohan Demers, John Liam Brooks, Brittany Lauren Smith, Mackenzie Lucille Jackson. And graduating cum laude with a 3.67 to 3.82 GPA, Dennis James Kuchta III, Benjamin A. Griffiths, Sabrina Wood, Garth Raymond Labar, Rebecca Gail Kinzinger, Clayton W. Hewlett, Jill Marie Henderson, Caitlin Mormon, Chris Anton Forelli, Serena Vandalin, Shayna Delane Lohman. Christina Adams graduated 10th in Honesdale High School's class of 2001. A high honor student and member of the National Honor Society, she attended Marywood University on a full academic scholarship, where she graduated magna cum laude. Christina was employed and promoted to head bookkeeper at Peck's Market main office. On August 20th, 2012, Christina's life was taken away by a senseless act of violence. It is her family's wish that her love of learning and drive to better herself and the lives of others be passed on to future generations. The recipient of this scholarship is the number 10 graduating senior in the class of 2016. This year's recipient is Lauren Bunnell. And for our final two awards, I ask that the students called come forward to receive their scholarships. The estate of Anna R. Scheuer presents the Anna R. and Walter Scheuer Scholarship to a graduating senior to assist the graduate in pursuing further education. This year's recipient is the Honesdale High School Class of 2016 salutatorian, Kylie A. Fermuth. The estate of Ernest W. Lemnitzer, a graduate in the Honesdale High School class of 1920, presents an annual scholarship to the valedictorian of the senior class. This year's recipient and valedictorian of the class of 2016 is Andrew Bachnovich. This concludes our awards presentation today. Please honor all of our award winners with your applause at this time. At this time, please welcome Wayne Highlands School District Superintendent, Mr. Gregory Frigoletto.
Good afternoon. Tough crowd. Good afternoon. It is my distinct honor to speak to you today at this magnificent celebration. Wayne Highlands School District is a unique and interesting place. Geographically, the district is the second largest in the state. We cover over 436 square miles. We're a third of the size of the entire state of Rhode Island. As a result, it remains a place whereby students enter ninth grade coming from three different zip codes, Damascus, Preston, and here in town at our middle school. The students that come from each of these locations wear those experiences like badges of honor, as they should. However, as Wayne Highland students, an interesting thing happens. Upon entering Honesdale High School, these students are no longer thought of as the Damascus kids, the Preston kids, or the middle school kids. Instead, they officially become what you see before you today. They become one. And in this case, they became the Honesdale High School class of 2016. Back in the spring of 2012, as eighth graders, during their ninth grade orientation, this group of students before you were told that although 2016 seemed very far off in the future, it would come quickly. I am sure they would agree that it did. During that same orientation, all of the speakers encouraged the students to get involved in anything and everything that high school had to offer, and that the more they did, the better the experience would be, and they did. They were reminded that they were coming from a time in their lives where the most difficult decisions they had to deal with up to that point were sometimes as simple as deciding between chocolate or vanilla, and that very soon the decisions they would face as high school students would be much more difficult ones, in fact, possibly life-changing. They were told that our responsibility was to prepare them for the next chapter in their lives. They sat at that orientation prepared for high school, and high school would prepare them for what was next. They blinked, we all blinked, and here we sit today. Sitting in this gymnasium, many different generations are represented. We have parents, grandparents, and possibly even great-grandparents among us. Each generation, arguably different, however, they have something unarguably in common. At some point, each generation considered or maybe even became concerned, wondering if the current generation, the kids of today, these graduates, would or could ever live up to generations past. Could they equal the generation famously referred to by Tom Brokaw as the greatest generation? Many wonder, what is wrong with these kids today? Across America, people argue that today's kids are dreadful compared to those that existed in our golden past. These same folks believe that we would all be better off if schools and kids could just be the way they used to be. They ask, are we going to be okay? Sure, it's true, times have changed, but are the changes really for the worse? Author Jamie Vollmer has defined it this way. He claims that many people suffer from a phenomenon he refers to as nostesia. Nostesia is a make-believe, debilitating mental condition that is a hallucinogenic mixture of 50% nostalgia and 50% amnesia, and it distorts rational thinking. In other words, simply put, we all pine for the past, but it really wasn't as great as we remember. For example, these are just a few of the very simple things that these graduates have never experienced that I'm sure many of us have. Having to call a movie theater to check on movie times. Finding you have no blank VHS tapes to record your favorite show a few minutes before it airs, and then deciding if you should record over the one that you've already recorded something on. How about taking film to be developed and finding that 99% of it is blurry? How about doing a report on cell structure and finding that the C volume of the encyclopedia is missing? They missed out on that. How about finding your favorite VHS movie and realizing that the last person that watched it put it away without rewinding it, and worse yet, you were charged when you returned it to Blockbuster? Ah, the good old days. Are today's kids really the first generation to be viewed this way? Is this so-called me generation unique from generations past? Consider this quote from 8th century BC Greek poet Hesiod. He said, I see no hope for the future of our people if they are dependent on the frivolous youth of today, for certainly all youth are reckless beyond words. When I was a boy, we were taught to be discreet and respectful of elders, but the present youth are exceedingly wise and impatient of restraint. Well, based on this quote, remember, from the 8th century BC, it's obvious that attempts to characterize a generation have been trendy for a long time, and that attempts to characterize a generation have also been inaccurate for a long time. At high schools across the Commonwealth and across this great nation, commencement ceremonies much like this are taking place, providing family, friends, and loved ones the opportunity to honor the accomplishments of graduating high school seniors. Throughout those ceremonies, I am sure that there will be much talk of the needs of society that must be met, all of them needing to be met by a generation that, sure, often spends more time in the virtual than the actual world, and whose friends and relationships with people are those that they've never even met. But let's go back to that earlier question. Are we going to be okay? I'm here to tell you that we will be better than okay. We will be great. Let me tell you about these kids today. These kids today are no good at anything but being awesome. They give hope for the future. These kids, these graduates, are more connected to the world than ever before. They are more accepting of others. They look out for one another. They are more educated and skilled than ever before. They are hard workers. They are healthier. They are high tech. They're inventive. They collaborate. They are creative and innovative. They are analytical problem solvers. They care about their environment. They're globally aware. They're critical thinkers and adaptive. And yes, through all of that, they are also under much more pressure than ever before. In education over the last several years, we have opted to operate under the guise of a sense of urgency, or in other words, the belief that our responsibility is of pressing importance. According to professor and author John Cotter, urgency is not driven by a belief that all is well or that everything is a mess, but instead that the world contains great opportunities. Even more so, urgency is not created by feelings of contentment, anxiety, frustration, or anger, but by a gut-level determination to move on and win now. As I conclude, I challenge the class of 2016 to move forward with a sense of urgency, like that described by Cotter. Allow that sense to lead you down an alert and proactive path. Be aware of the environment around you. Look for information relevant to your success and survival. Find what is essential not only to your own prosperity, but to future generations as well. And most of all, prove me right. We're not going to be just okay. We're going to be great. Thanks and good luck.
I am honored to introduce the Wayne Highlands School District Board members presenting diplomas today. With us today, we have Mrs. Kim Eldred, Mr. Robert Deal, and Mr. John Lowe. Members of the board, I am honored to present the class of 2016. The senior class of 2016, and I ask the audience to remain quiet until all seniors have received diplomas, returned to their places, and have been pronounced graduates. We have worked with them, with your children since they were small, to instill in them proper audience behavior and etiquette. At Storebridge, the students recite the Storebridge Promise each day, and at Damascus, Preston, and Lakeside, ready, respectful, and responsible is their motto. We expect our students to live by these mantras throughout their careers. We ask you, as the audience, to do the same. Our students have worked hard to get to this point. We are very proud of their efforts, and we are appreciative that you are with us today. However, we ask that all of our students are honored once all names have been called. Any calling out by the audience will result in the ceremony being stopped and the person's calling out being removed from the audience. This is embarrassing to all parties involved and puts your child and me in an uncomfortable situation. The class of 2016 and I appreciate your cooperation in making this a respectful and dignified ceremony and for providing all of our graduates the fair and respectful honor that they deserve. Janine Elizabeth Gallick. Andrew Peter Bachnovich. Kylie A. Firmeth. Nicholas James Miller. Garth Raymond Labar. Michelle Patricia Ann Yanakis. John Liam Brooks. Kenneth Monroe Coca. J. Duncan Cordaro. Samuel David Fulmer. Jordan Carl Gallo. Max Michael Goodwin. Clayton W. Hewlett. Gavin M. Hoffman. Alexander James Keeler. Thomas Kulikowski, Jr. Tristan Lewis Protzman. Charles Lewis Pikus. Tanner John Simon. Kyle Michael Strokes. Joshua I. Bloomgarden. Jonathan Biblioni. Mark T. Calkin. Gerard Lawrence DiMeglio. Matthew Mohan Demers. Mark Joseph Durdak. Chris Anton Forelli. Ryan Paul Fritz. Anthony Ryan Golson. Rodney Wayne Golson. Mason Michael Carmody. Stephen Thomas Albano. Julio A. Galarza, Jr. Spencer Philip Goyette. Benjamin A. Griffiths. Cody Walker Ginther. Adam Kelly. Sean R. Hager. Zachary William Grass. Lyle J. Hendel. Zachary John Hoffman. Julius Calvin Holbert. Morgan Scott Houghton. Justin Bruce Jay. Roger W. Kenyon. Kyle Costas Kirkoulis. Kai Conrad Klinger Hiller. Samuel L. Kraft. Dennis James Kuchta III. Ian David Langendorfer. Brandon Matthew Amato. Anthony Joseph Legatuda. Michael A. Landers. Jared S. Martin. Nathaniel Martin. Anthony McDevitt. Colin Michael McVeigh. Dylan Micheletti. Ryan P. Miller. Thomas A. Manila. Timothy Manella. Christian F. Maduno. Stephen J. Monteridis. Joseph R. Myers. Elijah Nell. Michael O. Norrie. Patrick Michael O'Neill. Alexander Martin Orthaus. Lucas Patton. Lucas E. Davis. Jacob Allen Pepper. Tristan James Petrosky. Justin James Rawls. Kyle James Reisner. Rex Dean Schweikofer. Jason D. Reed. Hunter Floyd Sherd. Garrett Anthony Semt. Jonathan Seppi. Jacob C. Schumacher. Kyle Matthew Stengel. Jack Elliott Perry. Tr- Travis M. Thompson. Isaiah R. Victor. Christopher Angelo Velasic. Bradley Mark Welsh. Cody Edward Welsh. Benjamin Daniel Card. Jacob C. Wilson. Samuel Stephen Keeley. Brooke M. Antone. Sarah Aronica. Lauren Marie Bunnell. Brianne Barbara Mayers. Sierra Allegra Gaglione. Kiera Stephanie Oakley. Gabriella Teresa Osageda. Hannah Osageda. Sarah Jill Thompson. Caitlin Lee Robbins. Zoe D. Wasserloff. Amanda L. Wallmaker. Dorothy Esther Woods. Lindsay Cook. Kaya Rose Lynch. Jill Marie Henderson. Melanie A. Bakanich. Molly Kathleen Benson. Sadie Ann Borsdam. Monica Paige Byron. Yendri E. Corella Santos. Kayla J. Compton. Jessica Marie Carney. Natalie Marie Tamlin. Sabrina Wood. Melanie Patrice Nacco. Brittany Alice Lossick. Olivia Ann Frigoletto. Cheyenne Davis. Hope Lynn Decker. Julia Ashley DeMedici. Rebecca Francis Fields. Jenna Lee Franciosa. Leanne G. Daly. Elizabeth C. Fritz. Jensen Patricia Gibbs. Lindsay Kate Hilton. Abigail Shea Hover. Mackenzie Lucille Jackson. Rebecca Gail Kinzinger. Annalise Rose Kobaba. Casey Denise Lebrecht. Amanda Elizabeth Lindy. Charlene Jo Pransky. Shana Delane Lohman. Emma Morgan Long. Emma Kathleen Firmstone. Jillian Helfrich. Emily Regina McVeigh. Haley Miranda Merritt. Carly Allison Menu. Carly Brooke Riefler. Caitlin Mormon. Jad E. Mullally. Jane Elizabeth Murphy. Riley Pauls. Mary Margaret Peck. Haley Rose Rock. Oriana Star Rex. Courtney M. Lyons. Serena Vandalin.
Olivia Rose Scarpolato. Haley Alexis Silent. Brittany Lauren Smith. Taylor Marie Smith. Zoe Ann Joyce Smith. Brianne Joy Stevens. Tiana Iola Ann Stevenson. Cameron Lee Tuttle. Anna Elizabeth Semler.
Adriana Grace Bender. Amanda J. Weidel. Bridget Ann Wood. Hunter Nicole Woods. I respectfully ask that everyone remain at their seats until all seniors have recessed from the gymnasium. Seniors will proceed to the Honesdale High School gym where they can be greeted by parents, family, and friends. Take that opportunity to please meet and greet with the seniors. Take pictures. This is a great memory for everyone. Again, please wait until all seniors and those of us on stage have recessed from the gym before you move from your seats. Seniors, by the power vested in me, by the Pennsylvania Department of Education and the Wayne Highlands Board of Education, I pronounce you graduates. I ask the audience to please rise and join us for the singing of the alma mater.